Purdue mechanical engineering students have designed an exoskeleton that could help tens of thousands of dogs with hip dysplasia. The malformed hip sockets can cause dislocations, swelling, and arthritis, leading to a lame, immobilized animal.
Our device is supposed to combat that by targeting dogs with mid to severe hip dysplasia by transferring the loads that they would be carrying on their hind limbs away from their hind limbs and into the forelimbs and into the body of the dog.
Jim Bergen led the team of four students who adopted their senior design project from another student team that launched the concept the previous semester. Ian Ashland said their interdisciplinary project required the team to work with researchers and technicians across campus to develop a lighter, better-fitting brace.
There are things that we learned in this semester that the previous eight semesters of college we really, you know, didn't learn, because that was all like, you know, doing the math of all the this. It was kind of some crisis management, some communication skills, that sort of thing. That'll help in the workplace.
Purdue veterinary technologist Kris Kazmierczak conducted trials on both models.
I'm really impressed with the work that they did and that with the design that they came up with the brace. They have taken it to the next step.
She thinks the device could eventually return mobility to animals that otherwise might be subjected to invasive hip replacement surgery or lifetime medication.
Some of these medications are a little bit harder on the liver and the kidneys as they're cleared from the body. So, you know, if you can ease that load on the patient, then this may be quite helpful for them.
The first model improved the animal's gait by 65%. The second test animal, Stella, also took well to the new device.
All dogs will respond a little bit to it, as anybody would. But over the course of the last week, we can essentially put it on and she can walk without any problem.
Stella's trial showed less stellar statistical improvement because her disease is not as advanced as some dogs, and the device still needs to be tweaked.
I believe it really does have potential to help, you know, society as a whole, because if you help animals, everybody's got a soft spot for dogs, and in the end you are helping somebody who can't help itself, and you're also helping the owner, because if this device works as planned, the owner will be able to actually step down the medication that it's on. So over time it will actually, you know, be a financial help as well.
Purdue has filed a preliminary patent on the device, giving the university 1 year to file a full patent on a brace that has already garnered worldwide attention. At Purdue University, I'm Ray Cubberley.